Welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. Today is November 27th, 2016. Today is the first Sunday of Advent. We have a guest pastor today. Pastor Pollock is on vacation, spending time with the family. Our pastor will be Pastor Jacob Lindsay Shaner.
St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. Our opening hymn is O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. This is November the 27th Sunday, the first Sunday of Advent. We're preparing for Jesus' coming to the world and Bethlehem born, and also for his second coming. Those are our emphasis, the things we're emphasizing during the Advent season. This hymn is from the Cologne group of hymns, 1790, and the 15th century music, French, combined German and French, German in Cologne, Germany, 1710, and French processional, 15th century Advent music.
For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, seated. At this time, we light the first of our Advent candles. It's a time when we lift up the expectation, not only of the coming Christ, but more especially the coming of Christ's kingdom. And as we light the candle, we will sing the first stanza of the Advent hymn.
Becky Dimitrov and her daughter Jamie and Jamie's husband are lighting the Advent candle.
Connie Singleton will be doing the first reading.
The first reading is from Isaiah, second chapter. The word that Isaiah, son of Amos, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. In days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest of the mountains, and shall be raised above the hills. All the nations shall stream to it. Many people shall come and say, "Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth instruction, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations, and shall arbitrate for many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Becky Dimitrov will be singing the song.
Gratify its desires. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
time for the gospel. And the gospel will be read by our visiting pastor, Pastor Jacob Lindsay Shader, who's filling in for our regular pastor. Pastor Pollock is out of town. Pastor Shader will be reading the gospel.
We will now have special music.
Thank you.
Lindsay Shaner will be giving the sermon.
I was told by Greg, blame Greg on this, that the people today are expecting something a little bit different. So if I don't stand in the right spot or if I don't come out at the right time, that's the reason for it. Blame Greg. One change that we decided after the early service is that we're going to change the closing hymn as well. And that's going to be hymn 250. We think that'll be probably easier to sing and one that we know a little bit better as well. I'll remind you a little bit later in the service. Do you like a good story?
Yeah.
I think most people do. And so I'm going to share a story with you that's rooted in Scripture. It's getting ahead of ourselves for the first week in Advent just a touch, but I'll try to weave some things together nonetheless. And yeah, there's some things here that you won't find in Scripture as well, but it's something I think you need to know about this particular story. It was a rough night for the innkeeper. And yes, I'm talking about Mr. No Room in the Inn, innkeeper. You see, it was a Saturday night of his 10-year class reunion. And there he was, surrounded by people he had not seen for years. And together they recalled stories that they hadn't thought about in ages. They had conversations about the old days that they had not talked about since, well, the old days. And what had made it so rough and what made it so bad for this innkeeper was that people had remembered how he had turned that young couple away. He turned away the pregnant mother, her husband, and that soon-to-be-born baby. Good Lord, they said, with no pun intended. She was just about ready to have her child, they said in hushed but rather smug voices, as if they would have done everything else differently. And so it was a very rough evening for this reluctant character in the story of all stories. He never really got out of town. After graduation, he sort of just floated from one job to the next, until he found steady employment there at the inn. This nice family-run business allowed him to visit with all kinds of people and visitors each and every day. The inn had become known for its warm and friendly old-world charm. That is, until our innkeeper spoke those five regrettable words, "No room in the inn." But before we tar and feather the innkeeper, we're going to jump ahead a number of years. 25 more years to be exact. It was now his 35th school reunion, and most of the same crowd had come back. And once again, he found himself surrounded by people he hadn't seen for years, recalling stories that they hadn't thought about in ages, and talking about the old days that they hadn't talked about since the old days. But life for our innkeeper was now radically different. So much had changed in those 25 years between reunions. To put it simply, a light had gone on for him. More precisely, the light light from God had gone on inside of him. The presence of that baby, whom he had turned away all those years before, had illuminated his life and transformed his life as well. The words and the ministry of Jesus had changed him. So everything was different now. Everything. He had even taken time off from work to go on a speaking tour, sharing his story in churches and in synagogues all over the country. He now talked about his life as being a follower of Christ. And in his story that he shared on this tour, the innkeeper spelled out the difference for him between hindsight and foresight. You know, hindsight is 20/20, isn't it? Am I right about that? We look back and we see things very clearly when we look back. That means when we look back on some episode of life, we have a clearer understanding of its significance from our new vantage point. For 2,000 years, people have been throwing indictments at the innkeeper for leaving Mary and Joseph and the baby out on that cold night. I think what most of us remember about the story is that there was nowhere for Jesus to lay his sweet dead. Perhaps one of the most tender of all Christmas carols, Away in the Manger, certainly tell us that. And even the gospel writers say something about foxes having holes and birds having nests. But the Son of Man has no place to lay his head. And so our perfect vision, 20/20 hindsight, allows us to say, well, of course, you and I would have made room if we had been there. Knowing what we know now, of course we would have gotten that hospital bed and we would have made room in our very own house. Of course, you and I would have hired a medical team to deliver that baby. And we would have gotten a news crew out to broadcast the whole event. Of course, you and I would have found counselors to help people interpret the meaning of his birth. And I'm sure you would have spearheaded a movement within this entire congregation to gather them with lit candles to stand vigil throughout the whole ordeal. But the truth is, we cannot change what's already been done. We cannot go back and change what is. But you and I can move forward to change what might be. And so, let's not settle for hindsight. What we want to have is foresight. And here's what that means. I want to be ready the next time Jesus shows up and wants to be born in my life. I want to be open the next time Christ wants a place to lay his head in my life. I want to be ready. I want to be ready the next time God stirs up some holy activity so that he might be right here among us. Why wouldn't we all want to be available for that? God moments. That's what those times are called when the Lord shows up in unexpected places in our lives. But sadly, we usually miss these moments because they pass by far too quickly. If we're not looking for them or ready for them, we simply miss them. In our gospel reading from Matthew 24 for this Sunday, Jesus was trying to convey to his disciples the difference between hindsight and foresight. Jesus said, looking forward to something is always better than looking back at anything. What Jesus was trying to do is instill in his followers the necessity of foresight. When he told them to keep awake and be ready. 10 different times in those 9 verses, Jesus either uses a phrase or a series of words that heightens that sense of urgency about his showing up. And so we're called to move from hindsight to foresight. Well, the innkeeper also learned the difference between apathy and anticipation. Apathy versus anticipation. Of course, there's a difference between apathy and anticipation. Apathy is an indifference about things with not much feeling or emotion to go with it. Anticipation, on the other hand, is like sitting at the edge of your seat, breathless, intently waiting for what comes next. But before we climb all over the innkeeper for missing an obvious and critical distinction, let's think about how easy this is for you and me even today. Think for a moment, if you will, about how it is when something you once held so dear becomes so commonplace in your daily life that it loses all impact. I don't know about this part of the Midwest, but the upper Midwest, where I served my first couple of parishes in Minnesota, Ole and Lena jokes were known by everybody, especially Scandinavian folks. They always seemed to break the ice if you told an Ole and Lena joke, and then people would somehow have a way of capturing the essence of what you wanted to say. Now here's one I think that could easily apply to me of German descent, but also people of other ethnic roots as well. Charming Lena says to her husband, Oli, "Oli, I'm so heartbroken. You never say you love me anymore." To which Oli replies, "Lena, I told you I loved you the day we was married. And if I change my mind, I will tell you." Well, wouldn't you agree? Ole has gotten a bit apathetic. And poor Lena is missing a whole lot of anticipation. And that's going to be a problem. When it comes to living with the love of Jesus and God coming into our lives, you and I cannot afford to be apathetic. And the words before us today from Jesus' lips have a sense of urgency when he says, "No one knows about the day or hour, not even the angels of heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know on what day your Lord is coming. You also must be ready, because the Son of Man will come at an hour when you do not expect him. You run the risk of slipping into apathy when you stop anticipating that Christ will show up. So the thought for today is, keep watch. Be ready. Anticipate not only the presence, presence of God, but also the Holy Spirit moving through your life. Where is Christ at work with you? If you never ask that question, you might just miss it. We're called to move from apathy to anticipation. So how about you? Do you see what the innkeeper finally saw when God's light came on for him? Instead of turning Christ away, the innkeeper invited Jesus into his life. With foresight that looked to the future, with anticipation that took him there, he realized how vacant his life had been, and he found room for what truly mattered the most. And likewise, in these Advent days that are leading up to Christmas, may you too find room for what truly matters most.
This is an American gospel hymn, but it was written by Presbyterian ministers in 1887. Elijah Hoffman and Anthony Showalter. Presbyterians, one was from Georgia, one was from Alabama. Southern hymn writers, Presbyterians, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Who was conceived by the Holy Spirit. the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
At this time, we continue our worship as we receive our offerings and tithes.
Ushers today are Mike and Debbie Cochran. This is the first Sunday of Advent, November the 27th, 2016, St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. We thank you for listening to us, watching us on YouTube. We have our services at 8 o'clock every Sunday. We're at the corner of Wittenberg and Columbia, Springfield, Ohio. We invite you to join us. We also have Sunday school at 9:15. We have another service, the one you're watching right now, at 10:30 a.m. every Sunday. We thank the people who gave the flowers today, Cindy and Les Pearson, who gave flowers on the chancel stands to the glory of God, presented by Les and Cindy Pearson and family in honor of Madeline and Michelle Everhart and Lillian Pearson for their birthdays. And also the other vase of flowers is given anonymous to the glory of God. This is the first Sunday of Advent, and we're spending our time now, this Sunday until Christmas, meditating on Jesus' coming into the world as a baby to save us from sins. And we had a lesson today. Our minister gave us a sermon on the inn and the no room at the inn for Jesus, but there is room for in our hearts for Jesus. We have the ushers coming forward, bringing the offering.
Closing hymn. 250.
This is an Advent hymn written by Carl P. Dahl. He was born in 1944, but the music is an English folk tune. This is the first Sunday of Advent, and this is an Advent hymn. Watching St. John's service. We're located at Wittenberg in Columbia, Springfield, Ohio, St. John's Lutheran Church. We're on YouTube. Anytime you want to tune us in, we're on YouTube. Tune in anytime for our broadcast. We're happy to bring you this service. We have a Christian school, which we hope will be starting again in January. It's no longer functioning, but call the church office if you're interested in our school. We have Sunday school every Sunday. At 9:15, we have 8 o'clock service and 10:30 service. We welcome you to join us. Also, call our churches if you're interested in helping the poor. We serve 8,000 meals a month to the poor. We dispense things that the poor need. Anybody who is our neighbor, we love our neighbor, anybody who's in need. So call the church office if you're willing to help us. Thank you for joining our worship service this Lord's Day. I hope and I pray that God will continue to bless you this day and all your days. We will pray for you, continue to pray for us in our YouTube ministry. I'm Dr. Sally Abbott, Dr. Jim Pompucius, Karen Dietrich, Linda Fox. We all work together to bring you this broadcast. You can worship with us virtually if you're unable to come worship in person, which we'd love to have you worship in person. Come to us virtually, worship with us, and receive communion. Even if you're unable to attend here, God will be with you. Jesus will be with you, his body and blood. You can receive that 2 Sundays a month. And if you can come in person on 6:30 at our chapel, we have communion every week, 6:30 on Wednesday evenings. If you want to receive the body and blood of Jesus Christ, help you to function through these difficult times. We ask God to bless you and keep you forever. Amen.